Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Empressive Channel. T.I. and his wife, Tiny, joined Jada Pinkett Smith on her show, Red Table Talk, and they talked about T.I.'s recent controversial statements about his daughter. Now, if you don't know the backstory to this, earlier this month, T.I. made some very inflammatory statements about taking his daughter to the gynecologist just to monitor her virginity.
So have you had the sex talk with your daughters?
Have I? We go.
Which, by the way, your daughters are so beautiful.
Yeah,
so
beautiful.
So, thank you so much.
I'm sure you have her hands full.
And like, yeah, the other one's 18, so she definitely knows about sex.
See, this is the thing.
It's Deyjah, right? She's 18,
yes,
right?
Deyjah's yes, Deyjah's 18, just graduated high school now. And she's attending her first year of college, ooh, figuring it out for herself. And yes, not only have we had the conversation, we have yearly trips to the gynecologist to check her height.
Oh, you okay?
I'm done with you right now.
So, you know,
do you go with her?
She's a prisoner.
Yes, I go with her.
You go with her.
Somebody check on Deyjah.
I go with her.
She is a prisoner.
So let me tell you, right? So this is one time go. I think this might have been after her 16th birthday, and this is what we do. Like, you know, right after the birthday, we celebrate.
And we go and check her hymen after.
And then,
what the fuck?
You know, usually like the day after the party, she's enjoying her gifts. I put a sticky note on the door. Gyno.
No.
Tomorrow, 9:30.
Oh, this is great.
And so look, right? So we'll go, you know what I mean? We'll go and we'll sit down and then the doctor will come and talk. And, you know, the doctor's maintaining a high level of professionalism. Mm-hmm. He's like, well, you know, sir, I have to, you know, in order for me to share information. I say, Deyjah, they want you to sign this.
They want you to sign this right now. I need to know if your hymen's still there.
So we can share information. Is there anything that you would not want me to know? Oh, okay. See, doc, ain't no problem.
You are the worst.
And so, then they come and say, okay, I just want you to know that there are other ways besides sex that the hymen can be broken.
Right.
Like bike riding.
Uh-huh. Really?
Athletics. Horseback riding.
That's aggressive. that is aggressive
and,
riding.
You know, just right. other forms of athletic physical activity.
Is she an athlete?
Can no.
Okay. So,
there you
so
go.
I say,
you're like, sorry, I say, look, doc.
I say, look, doc.
She's not.
She don't ride no horses. She don't ride no bikes. She don't play no sports, man. Just check the hymen, please. And give me back my results.
Oh, dear.
Expeditiously.
Expeditiously.
But I will, you know, I will say as of her 18th birthday, her hymen is still in.
Oh, my God.
Deyjah, you are an angel.
When T.I. made these comments, the internet was in uproar and they dragged him online. Even his daughter, Deyjah, liked comments on Twitter about him, saying that he was possessive and controlling. It was also reported that Deyjah unfollowed her father on Instagram, and she also shut down her social media pages because she has been getting a lot of unwanted attention ever since T.I. exposed her personal information. Now, when I made a video about this, I went in on T.I. I dragged him because I did not feel like what he did or what he said was appropriate at all. But he did get a chance to clarify what he meant on the Red Table Talk, and this is what he said.
Right.
Let me go set this record straight. Never said I was in any exam room. That is an assumption.
Right.
That is a falsity.
Got it.
I never said that it was being done present day.
Right.
As an 18-year-old.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She was 15 and 16 years old at the time.
And I never said that her mother wasn't present.
Right.
Her mom was present every time.
Together.
Right.
You know, he was just, you know, most fathers don't go, but he was just present.
Right.
Yeah.
And he didn't make the doctor's appointment.
No.
It was already, you know, appointment.
And all of these things, all of this narrative, this false narrative has just been sensationalized.
So at the time, her mother welcomed your presence and your daughter did too?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And that was never any objection.
Right.
She did have a problem with me talking about it, however.
Right.
And I understand that.
Yes.
And I am incredibly apologetic to her
for that.
Yeah.
To her.
Yeah.
To you, sweet baby Deyjah. Not to any of these other strangers, any of these weirdos who, you know, just kind of toss lies around for
right.
fun.
Yeah.
She understands my intentions and she knows yes. who I am. She knows who I've always been.
Right.
And I think that that allows a certain level of understanding.
So that was a part of what T.I. said in response to the backlash he got. And obviously he was doing this for damage control. And I will say this, I don't think that T.I. is a bad father. I did judge him very harshly in my last video, but I got a chance to sit down and listen to his perspective. And he's really a product of his environment. He has a very old school style of parenting. He believes in being a stern patriarch, and he was taught to protect and provide. And the way he knows how to show love is by being protective, but when his ego kicks in, he comes across as being overprotective or controlling. And I do believe this is one of the things that he wasn't quite understanding when Jada tried to break it down to him. But there's a clear-cut difference between a father who guides and educates his child versus a father who might overprotect or police his child. Both of those fathers may love their children just the same, but one will instill fear in that child and the other one will instill respect. And I do think T.I. is using fear as a way to keep his daughter quote-unquote pure or a virgin. He said he tells her to stay away from engaging in any intimate activities with boys because they're too young to have good intentions toward her and they'll only defile her.
You know, as she begins to engage and socialize, just, hey man, listen, keep your expectations low. You can't get your feelings wrapped up in this now. This is a physical urge. This is animalistic urges taking over right here. This is not an emotional, romantic encounter for this gentleman. So, I don't think it is.
Do you think that's the part you were trying to protect her from?
Yes, because yes. if you aren't
able...
You
feel like young boys that age would not be able to care for
defile
your
and destroy.
Daughter. Care for your daughter emotionally in the way in which you think she deserves.
Absolutely.
And that's what it was about.
I mean, definitely, all of the above. Then she definitely should be afraid for what could potentially come from, you know, doing the do.
Right, yes.
I'm being criticized because I'm willing to go above and beyond to protect mine.
Right.
And I'm talking about all of the little slimy, grimy, chubby-fingered little boys who want to just come and defile mm-hmm. and destroy the sanctity that I have. Hey, man, listen, I'm just saying, right? I don't understand anything that is the most important thing to me in my life. I am going to deal with that with very extreme care.
Mm-hmm.
Now, T.I. said he wants to protect his daughter from the slimy, grimy guys out there, but I have to be honest. If T.I. wants his daughter to stay away from guys like that, he has to start leading by example. And when I say leading by example, I mean he shouldn't just say it. He needs to show her how a man is supposed to treat a woman, starting with how he treats his own wife. And I'm gonna keep it real. T.I. has not treated his wife, Tiny, the best. We've heard the rumors. We've seen what went down on national TV where Tiny called T.I. out for sleeping around with other women. We've seen how T.I. talks down to Tiny and etc. So T.I. wants his daughter to stay away from guys like him. But it's easy to say stay away from this guy, stay away from that guy because all they want to do is use you. But why don't you show her an example of the man she should be with? Once you do that, you won't have to worry about her choosing to be with some guy who's gonna break her heart or use her or mistreat her. You won't have to worry about any of that. And you won't have to worry about her giving any of those knuckleheads who lust after her the time of day. Also, he should encourage his sons not to be like those knuckleheads. I don't understand why there's a leeway for his boys to do what he doesn't want his daughter to do. I think he should hold all of his children to the same standard. But anyway, those are just my two cents. Like I said before, I don't think T.I. is a bad father. I do think some of the comments he made were pretty outrageous, but he does love his daughter and he means her well. But I do hope this whole recent controversy is a learning lesson for him. There are certain things he has to be more sensitive about when it comes to his daughters, and intimate information regarding their womanhood is one of those things. Anyway, tell me what you all think about this video down below. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and share this video if you care. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!